comes back, just like I knew he would. The core hums in his pack. The monument's calling for it. Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next. The Bastion's a place of peace, but we can hold our own if we have to. Ain't much Kid can't handle with hammer and bow in hand. The windbags used to be all right, then the Calamity took the floor out from under him. Picked up traces of other cores while the Kid was out. The Breakers used to come here for target practice. Used to play a little game. See who could bust the most targets in the fewest shots. Focused. He's armed. And he's off. Shot just happens in a flash. It ain't done bad at all. He returns with some of the materials we need. Thank you. had enough of the Breakers' barracks. Takes practice, and a mighty strong bow helps too. Solid performance. Always much to say. Squirt cider will toughen you right up. Too bad about the musty aftertaste. In better days, the melting pot was sealed tighter than the skin on the squirt. Of all the plans to survive the calamity, it had to be stab weeds. There's a core, he figures it ought to be deeper down. He cuts down every stab weed like there's gonna be a prize for it. core stuck inside one of those fancy cages. Some of the stuff lying around is downright dangerous. He throws a switch. Now what could possibly go wrong? Quite a bit, as it turns out. The cage starts lifting from the core ever so slow. All Kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in. Not every squirt's born bad. Some spring to the Kid's defense. Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while. Scumbags don't take kindly to interlopers. Even some gas fellas take his corner. Heard he popped that mean old foreman. At this rate, maybe 5 more minutes. Maybe 30. Hard to tell. Squirts get real territorial around the core. Then a shipment of free samples shows up. It ain't all bad, as the Kid finds some spices from the motherland, tax-free. One thing's for sure, that cage is awful heavy. Troublesome scene, to be sure. A few moments left, and the core goes free. 10, 9, 8, 7. You give or take a few seconds. Finally, the core's within reach. And done. He's got it. Just gotta get to the nearest barge. I still remember the look on his face after that one. The old world's finished, but the new world's just getting started. A lot of things need fixing up in this world, and we can start right here. Kid packs a special surprise in every one of those arrows. Turns out those old bones still have some spark in them. He little Zolwood oil and that blade shines like a light. Folks voyaged across the boundless sea to found Ceylandia. It was good living here for a while. Windbag Ranch was built for gathering squirt extract in copious supply. Ain't nothing more healthful. Some folks showed up to make a fast buck with nothing but a knife. Other folks came to train their throwing arms. Slippery little devils. Still others use the place to test their finest blades. Kid cuts all of them down soon enough. Kid comes back from Windbag Ranch smelling good and ripe. Sometimes a single look says it all. Couples used to walk the sundown path. Kid ain't here for pleasure, though. But then, somebody gets to the core before the kid. floor starts giving way under the lightest step, a single panic squirt could bring the whole place down. So could a reckless kid, for that matter. Fragments of the old world rain from the sky. Well, the path ain't exactly open to visitors no more. Security's all fired up. See, the path was intended for leisurely strolling and such. The calamity changed everything, even where the wind blows. Well, if we mastered the winds in the old days, we can do it again. But the question is, who else could have taken the core? Well, ain't no survivor stole the thing. Scumbag ate it by mistake. Tough break. Unlike the kid, that core ain't coming back. They used to ship live munitions down the path. These wires to toss those things are plenty far away. Even gas fellas need some shut-eye from time to time. They get real cranky when you wake them up. Quick and careful is the only way to go. In all this toil, Kid keeps coming back to an overwhelming question. Who else could have survived the calamity? So he didn't find the core that time, but that ain't about to stop us. What else is there to say? War machetes are so quick, you gotta keep a good grip on them. No place better than Trapper Shingle for learning to tread light and shoot straight. Trappers had to tread real careful here. Else take a nasty fall. They train themselves by clearing out the targets while not clearing out the floor. good trapper knows never to take a step till the time is right. Expert trapper's got something extra to give him an edge. Kid decides to keep working his aim and footwork on the shingle. Best time to pick a new spot was when swapping magazines. Decent trapper wouldn't walk away empty-handed. To think a rickety place like the Shingle survived, and so little else did. The dead welcome him with open arms. calamity took everybody after all. Kid sees it plain, frozen faces all around. You don't much care to see him. Not like this. These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close. Someone who ain't like Mr. Beckley and his kindly wife. It was someone like him. Kid sees him there agape, in the flesh. It's a snag or two trying to get to him. He ain't about to stop. No matter what. He's got so many questions after all. Just ain't got time for answers. The Tunda brothers didn't make it. They never saw what it was like beyond the walls. Nor did the bird boy. Didn't make it. The Jawsons. They didn't make it. Grady Sr., Grady Jr., they didn't make it, but him, he survived. Kid finds proof enough that man ain't from around here. Just think, without that man, we wouldn't be here right now, would we? The core survived as well. Kid does what he has to do. What do you say to a man who's seen too much? Kid hasn't a clue, but he says this. We have to go. Please. He's a proper gentleman, that man. His name is Zulf. No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other for the first time. For Zulf, Ceylandia was like a second home. He's real worried about his first home, too. Far to the east. We all lost loved ones in the calamity, he says. I don't know how I'm gonna go on without mine. He was born in the Tazzil terminals. The Ura sent him on a mission of peace to our city. And he's lived here ever since. We fought the Ura decades ago, but that was then. Things are different between us now. That ought to make those fangs sink in nice and deep. That's why this place is coming together. That's why things are gonna be all right. Well, look what we have here. The lost and found. Here, Kid takes fragments of the old world and makes them whole again. We track down a couple more cores near the edge of the city. No use praying to the gods these days. No time for it either. Kid says a little prayer anyway. Couldn't hurt, right? Pith Orchard. Place is a dead end in more ways than one. Well, the gods are long gone now. And the Orchard Core, it's long gone too. Seems Pith ain't much of a watchdog. The gods don't care about trinkets, but the kid ain't no god. Pith stood for something once. Something real. In time, though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration. Pith makes a decent scarecrow, at least. Then Pith lights up like a rodeo. Ain't easy punching through his hide. Kid breaks him to bits. Must have been guarding that shrine. So what'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off? Piv. Kid don't need favors from the likes of Pith. Well, if the gods are alive, they must be plenty sore. Popping windbags is hard enough. No need to get the gods involved. person kid tampered with that shrine. Kid ain't found a core, but at least he found Zulf's precious shrine. Now we can build a shrine of our own, though I got some alternatives in mind. Zulf doesn't touch the thing. Says the God of Commotion is no children's toy. The Ura feared the gods. We turned them into toys, put their faces on our walls. All it takes is some fragments, and the Bastion makes it good as new. The accused always got a fair shake in Ceylandia. Some used to take the bullhead trial. Survive the trial without taking a scratch, you'd walk away a free man. Taught folks three things. First, a good defense is a good offense. Second, you gotta always watch your back. Third, ain't no godlike bull up there gonna sink it. smarter ones knew when to just step aside and let things go. Well, a kid always wanted to compete in the Bullhead trial. There's only one way in the Cinderbrick Fort. Sure, the city marshals may be gone, but now the fort's crawling with windbags. The calamity was mercy. Windbags ain't so lucky. They've been left to freeze or starve or face the kid. Windbags, young and old, keep fighting for the fort. Marshals left the kid a parting gift. Something the windbags just can't handle. Something that'll punch clean through their greasy hides. Windbags ain't much different from normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay and a decent meal. The Calamity drove the Windbags topside. A lot of them wound up here in this very fort. Business underground like in the old days. Windbags can't use the martial supplies, but the kid sure can. As for the Windbags, Cinderbrick gave them enough heat and metal to munch on for a while, though the fort ain't theirs by right. Can't blame them for wanting it, though. So many of those sorry things holed up inside that old fort. He's blasting everything in sight with that newfangled musket. Kid's stash of grenades is there for him if things get even worse. Plane gone haywire. Windbags gummed up the works. ain't afraid of getting burned. Kid used to dream of getting a Marshal's badge, but not like this. The skyway is a welcome sight after all that. And now ain't nothing left for nobody down at Cinderbrick Fort. Kid shows up just as Ulf's telling me about his own journey to the city. Zulf's travels ain't much compared to what the kids had to go through for all this. The memorial. Here, yeah, kid can pay respect to the old world and earn it in kind. The valediction. Just another one of my sketches. Nothing more. Words can't express what happened, but they're all I got. Seems the only thing the Calamity saved for Zulf was his smoking pipe. Poor kid collapses after just one drag. Only good thing ever come out of the past is history. Thank you. years up with a kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started. Fair to say he's led a hard life. Supposing what he says in his sleep ain't no lie. He never knew his old man, but he had his mama to take care of. Frail thing with pure white hair like his. Having his mama's hair did the kid no favors while he was growing up, but he learned to hold his own out there. School ain't working out, so the kid signs up for a turn on the rippling walls. Make his mama some money. Thanks to folks like the kid, the walls kept Ceylandia safe from whatever's out there. The elements, the Ura, you name it. Once the kid done his time, he hurried on home. Turns out his mama's time was done too. The city had nothing for him. The money he'd been sending home was nowhere to be found, either. So what'd the kid do? Why, he went right on back to the walls for another 5 years. In the history of Ceylandia, nobody's ever volunteered for a second shift on the walls. Kid learned to fend for himself, learned to build, learned to break. Time the kid earned good standing with the marshals. They trusted him to scout out farther than anybody. One night, on one of his expeditions, the ground beneath him shuddered, cracked, and split apart. He saw nothing where the world used to be. The calamity happened just like that. All the kid had to work with was his hammer and the clothes on his back. Through twisted streets, he ran with nothing but the city crest and an old stranger's voice to guide him. Finally arrived at Ceylandia's vaunted safe haven, he and no one else. Oh. But then, all he got was more thankless work from a man who ain't even asked his name. What was I saying? Anyway. Sure, I may be the one who dreamt up the walls and the bastion, but the kid made him real. Not me. I'd like to say I'll never forget him, or what he's doing, what he's done. I surely would. The marshals seem like good men, he says. They treated him with dignity. Zolf brought his antique smoking pipe all the way from the terminals. Even since the Urus surrendered to us, the marshals kept a wary eye on him. Ain't never letting go of his old friend with a sturdy grip like that. Now he can shoot that fang repeater all day long. You want to tune a scrap musket, you start with the barrel. Finders, keepers. Zolf offers to help me plot the skyways for the kid. At least the calamity hasn't touched the stars, he says. Kid takes another drag, goes out like a light. There's something you should know about the kid, but let me take it from the top. Thank you. up with a kid. Hardly had a moment's rest since all this started. We could always see the stars. We just never could reach them, no matter how high we built. The city's unwanted things all met their end in the yard. Folks who fouled up would do their time here, smashing things to bits. The quicker they worked, the sooner they could go. Folks learned to plant their feet and put their backs into it. Would plot a course to navigate that sea of junk. A good day smashing could feed a family for a week. Ever want to just smash things for a while, you know where to go. The Langston River flowed free and wild till the Calamity drank it all up. Maybe all that water just grew wings and flew off. Riverbanks swarming with windbags. They're so bent on finding the core, they hardly notice the kid. Lucky for him, a certain famous ferry barge is still afloat. Weepin' Nelly. She sends some squirts crying home as she leaves port. Maybe Nelly knows the way to the core. Maybe she can slip right past all the clamor on the coast. Or maybe not. A security skiff pulls up portside. Nelly's just another windbag to those guns. Just then, the windbags notice who she's sailing with. They're pretty steamed about what happened at Cinderbrick. They try to cut her off. They try to slow her down. They try to knock her out. Well, Weepin' Nelly tries harder. Try as she might, though, she hits a snag. Kid's gotta help her get untangled. Favors for favors. picked a good spot for a break, because the core is right there. Then the kid hears an unusual sound, like 100 flapping wings. They had their own eyes on the core. But why? Well, kid ain't got time to think it over just yet. He finds Weepin' Nelly raring to go. Turns out she's got a special surprise for when the water's getting rough. She's gonna need a little help with all them pickers. Traffic things think they're king of the roost now. Rest of us only wish we could fly in times like these. Security skiffs keep on coming to the starboard side. Don't seem to care what they shoot, as long as they hit something. Windbags get an even better idea. They aim to smash with Minnelli's splinters. Just gotta make one last stop. With a last breath, Nelly gets the kid to solid ground. Solid ground in Picker Country. They want that core real bad. Might be they want it just as bad as a kid. Kid shoes him off, knowing they'll be back. Know how many times Kid nearly fell off the barge back there? A good couple of times. Now, listen close. You should remember this next part. Why go to Prosper Bluff? Used to take an enterprising man or a plain old fool to venture out that far. The city was the most beautiful place in the world. We all knew that. But on the other hand, some folks just yearn to see the things they're told they can't. And that's why you go to Prosper Bluff, ain't it? There, the kid hears something he ain't heard in a long while. How's it go again? Well, no point explaining what happens next, right? Suffice it to say, kid ain't coming home empty-handed. And besides, it's like the song goes. They'll be here before too long. Darn near celebrated when the kid got back, didn't we? Zolf never thought he'd see a fellow Ura again. We become fast friends. Calamity has that effect on people. But there was more to be done. There was one last core to find. Kid surprised when I tell him there's only one core left. I shouldn't have believed it either. Behold, the Pantheon. Most of the Ura never got a taste of Ceylandia's fine goods, unless they were born and raised in the city like Zia here. Sure, the world's all gone to pieces farther than the eye can see, but leave it to this gal to point out the amazing view. Girl tried to run away from home one time, but the marshals stopped that, didn't they? So many secrets in there, and she can't even read it. Her father's own journal. A scientific journal written in Zolf's native tongue. He learned so much from it. Too much. If only I'd known half the secrets of the Calamity were tucked away in that book, I'd have worked a translator right away. Fetching fizz is like a mouthful of nails, but the benefits are worth it. Come on, give the little tyke a break. He ain't all that shy. We tracked the final core beyond the city to the wilds. The wild unknown. Place can eat a man alive. The place is so raw, even the Calamity couldn't cook it. Not all of it. Know what's better than having to sling a pistol in a fight. Having two. Savage things lurking at every turn. Pincushions ain't the worst of it either. Good thing pin cushions can't see where they're shooting. Pecker's got the core, like they're built in a bastion of their own. The welcoming committee scrambles to attention. Didn't expect the kid so soon. They shouldn't have let the guard down. Getting that core was one thing. Getting out's gonna be another. He digs his way out of the clearing, but the wilds won't let him go without a fight. Wallflowers survive the calamity. It toughened him up. Same goes for the kid. Best take it real slow when pincushions are afoot. Slinger Jawson's old outpost is all that's left of him. By now, kid's got more needles in him than stab weed. He's faster than a slinger with those guns. Don't ever turn your back on a pincushion. A handful of windbag shipments made it out this far. Kid's seen the last of them. Kid's roused up half the wilds by now. Then kid gets the feeling he's being watched. Not by me, by a lunkhead. And lunkheads ain't fond of two-legged animals. Hit him anywhere but the hindquarters and he only make him mad. Wild green pineapples, about the only good thing out here. Sees a smooth black stone coughed up by the calamity. Be seeing plenty more. The wilds already reclaimed this place. He's anxious to get back. After all, he's got the final core. His journey's over, right? Well, no, it ain't. Not by a long shot. Kid knows something's up when we ain't there to give a warm welcome. See, Zulf and I were just wrapping up a heated discussion. Zulf can barely muster the words. The calamity failed, he says, but I will not. And with that, Zulf leaves us here, alone. Zulf cursed the city, cursed the Bastion, cursed me, said he was going home. When Zulf got through reading that journal, he just snapped, started smashing up the monument till I tried to stop him. Zulf banged up the monument pretty bad. But there's a way to put it back together. The shards. We're gonna need all of them to nurse the Bastion back to health. We ain't much for pleasantries. Never could ask for a song. Takes a lot of moving pieces to make a dependable sidearm. Can't be too careful these days. It wasn't fixed. It was unbroken. The city brought the shards to the wilds. Now the kid's gonna bring them back. After Zulf's little episode, kid sets off in search of shards. First stop, Jawson Bog. You'll get lost in that bog, I told the kid, and I won't be able to guide you back. Well, I let him go. What else could I do? What could any of us do? Zulf put us in a real bind. Hurt the Bastion bad. But the shards can make it better. They're like smaller doses of the Corps' medicine. Shame the only place to fill that prescription is out here in the wilds. This place is intoxicating. Don't know where he's gone. Might be gone for good, for all I know. Wherever he is, it's somewhere I've never been. Somewhere I never want to go. Welcome him with open arms. Kid pops him good. That a survivor? No, ma'am. It's a lonesome ghost of a gas fella. Say to a kid who's seen too much. I'm Zulf of the Ura. Pleased to make your acquaintance. Now the kid sees something stranger still. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds beggars, lunkheads, wallflowers, pincushions, vine apples, swamp weeds, ankle gaiters. Sets foot inside one of Ceylandia's famous watering holes. He has the nerve to flash the shield he stole. The security's just gonna have to straighten it out. Succeeds where the calamity failed. Would you look at what he did to poor old Rondé the bartender? Proper story is supposed to start at the beginning. It's so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world's alright, snoozing there on a rock in the sky. He wakes up. I'm just fooling. He sees what's left of the rippling walls. Years of work undone in an instant. He sees what's left of Piff the Bull. sees what's left of his lifelong friend. Thought we'd lost him, but he finally comes to. The shard ain't lost either. Not anymore. Now to find a ticket out of this hole. Bootlickers dig their nasty thorns into his heels. Ever heard of a lung blossom? It's bigger than the stories say. Hard to get a sure footing in the bog. The breath on that thing, like a scumbag sprung a leak. They say one whiff of lung blossom can make you lose your mind. Well, the kid prunes it down to size somehow. Mother only knows what happened in the bog. Kid never much cared to speak of it. A shard is like a poor man's core, but beggars can't be choosers. That's it. A few more shards like that, and we'll be back in business. A single shard can breathe new life into this place. The shard's got enough juice to spruce up any of these places. Ain't saying much, but that's the greatest forge in all the city. We talk a little here and there. Oh, his manners ain't so bad. The city tried to use the shards to stake out the wild. So much for that plan. Ankle gators used to roam the wilds, and they nested at Rothus Lagoon. Many a tale folks used to scare their children straight originated here. All kinds of beasts what don't know up from down, still lurking about. Only the city's brushers knew their way around the lagoon. These beasts, they don't like company. Even the brushers learned to fear this place. They used to think that ankle gators were extinct. The lagoon's got plenty of other dangers, of course. Turns out Queen Anne got a hold of a shard. Ankle gators love shiny things. Know what smells worse than an ankle gator's breath? A stinkweed. Can't resist. Can't get hasty in a place like this. Can't fight Queen Anne without the proper tools. rushers use their pikes to keep their distance around here. Now the kid can do the same. Sharp sticks make Queen Anne nervous, so she backs off a bit. Kid's got a mean throwing arm. Those pincushions been living off the ankle gator scraps. Queen Anne can't fit down some of these narrow paths. Queenie leads the kid into some kind of twisted trap. One bad step in that tall grass and he's Queen Anne's lunch. He holds his ground. Seems the queen's running out of options. The closer you get to an ankle gator's lair, the thicker the tall grass grows. Kid's gotta make a run for it. They say you can't hurt an ankle gator unless it's raining. And it ain't raining. Scared a bunch of peckers out of hiding. Seems even stinkweeds know to stay away from the queen. Ankle gators don't much care for their young. That's why there ain't many around. Wanna know how to find an ankle gator lair? You use a kid as bait. The shard's sitting in plain view. Now she's coming for him. She's got nowhere else to go. He's got it, and now to finish her off. Started to get annoyed. Rest in peace, Queen Anne. That was for the brushers. It's done what needed to be done. Queen Anne's reign is over. We even got a crown jewel. All that trouble for a single shard. But you know what? It was worth it. The memorial may be finished, but our part is far from over. That Gator's a crazy gal, but so is the gal who promised to look after her. They said Queen Anne was just a folktale. Now there's living proof she ain't. He ain't big on small talk. The next shard should be farther out there in the wild. Trappers would have been impressed with how the kid handled the shingle. fixer brushes pike, you just need a good length of knife bark. He's made a right comfortable bed for all those bullets. Ever felt this old wood gourd like picking up broken glass barehanded? As old wood grove, marshals learn to make every shot count. The trick was to pop all those nasty gourds without wasting ammo. Most marshals didn't get far on the first few tries. Had to catch a bunch of those gourds in a single shot. Funny thing about muskets is they work best up close. It took a keen eye, not an itchy trigger finger. Marshals did more than just stand around shooting, of course.